Today we shall study about the pool boiling. What is pool boiling? Pool boiling is that which occurs when an electrically heated wire is immersed in a pool of stagnant water. Nukuyama was the first investigator who experimentally investigated the pool boiling phenomenon. He immersed an electrical resistance wire, nichrome electrical resistance wire, into a body of saturated water at atmospheric pressure, and he initiated boiling on the surface of the wire by passing current through it. He measured heat flux and temperature of the wire by measuring the voltage and current passing through the wire. He obtained the pool boiling curve, which shows the variation of heat transfer coefficient or heat flux as a function of temperature difference between the wire and water saturation temperature. There are mainly three regimes of pool boiling: free convection regime, nucleate boiling regime, and film boiling regime. The pool boiling regime, pool boiling curve is shown in the figure. It shows the function of variation of H versus delta T. Now, first, free convection zone. Here, wire temperature is only a few degrees above the saturation temperature of water. Heat transfer from the wire to the water takes place by free convection or natural convection, and it is seen that heat transfer coefficient increases linearly or very slowly with respect to delta T. In nucleate boiling, vapor bubbles are formed on the heater surface and vapor bubbles will propagate through the water. In the nucleate boiling also, there are two regimes, regime 2 and regime 3. In regime 2, the vapor bubbles formed on the preferred sites on the heater surface will grow in size and will get detached from the heater surface, but after traveling some distance upward, they will collapse or disappear. They will not be able to reach the surface of water. Then, with increase in temperature delta T, the vapor bubble generation rate becomes so high that, and nucleation sites also are numerous, and continuous columns of vapor are generated over the heater surface. In regime 3, thus a very high heat transfer coefficient is achieved due to agitating action of the bubbles. H varies very rapidly with delta T until a maximum value of critical heat flux is reached or a peak heat flux is reached. Nucleate boiling is followed by a film boiling regime. In film boiling, what happens? A vapor film covers the heater surface. The vapor film will act as a resistance, will offer resistance to heat flow, and also reduces the liquid to heater contact. Therefore, H is found to decrease in the film boiling regime. In the film boiling is again three zones are there. Regime 4, the vapor film formed is not stable. Vapor film is formed and it collapses. No stable film is formed. With increase in temperature delta T, it is found that a stable film is formed on the heater surface, and the value of H obtained is found to be minimum for stable film boiling. Again, with increase in temperature difference delta T between the wire and the water saturation temperature, the vapor film temperature, vapor film also gets heated. The vapor film temperature becomes so high to initiate radiation phenomena. Radiation will start comes into play, and vapor film radiates heat. And again, H increases with respect to delta T. Thus, these are the various three regimes of the pool boiling. Now, I will discuss correlations to determine nucleate boiling heat flux and the value of critical heat flux or maximum or departure from this. I will again one more thing. This peak heat flux is called as a peak heat flux or critical heat flux or departure from nucleate boiling, DNB, departure from nucleate boiling, or it is also called as a burnout point. Why it is called burnout point? Because when the critical heat flux, when the at certain value of temperature difference, when the peak heat flux is reached and entire heater surface is covered by a vapor film, if you continue heating the wire, then the heat is not taken away by the liquid, because as you know, the film boiling decreases the water to heater contact, and this may cause the burnout of the wire. That is why it is called as a peak heat flux or burnout point. Now we shall determine the heat transfer correlations in the boiling regime. So here you can see here nucleate boiling regime. Yes. Rosenvo was the scientist who determined the experimentally proposed the following formula for finding the heat flux in the nucleate boiling regime. The formula is shown here. It is shown here. Cpl delta T divided by HFG PRL raised to n is equal to CSF into bracket Q by mu L HFG square root sigma dash divided by G rho L minus rho V raised to 0.33. This is the expression for finding the heat flux in the nucleate boiling regime. What is the CPL? CPL is a specific heat of saturated liquid. CSF is a constant whose value depends upon the surface to heating surface and fluid combination. Heating surface to fluid combination. Just now I have explained on this thing pool boiling curve. It was a nichrome wire water combination. Then HFG is latent heat operation. And G is gravitational acceleration. Then PRL is Prandtl number of the liquid. Q is heat flux, boiling heat flux. Delta T is the temperature difference between the wire and the saturated water. Mu L is viscosity of saturated liquid. Rho L and rho V are the density of liquid and vapor, saturated liquid and saturated vapor. And sigma dash is the surface tension of liquid vapor interface. Surface tension of liquid vapor interface. So these things, CSF, the value of CSF table is available. Say for water copper combination, CSF is 0.0130. For water scored copper, it is like this. For water platinum, it is 0.0130, like this. So it is for a heater surface and liquid combination CSFR given. Okay, then we are sigma dash also one table is there. This table gives liquid vapor surface tension for various liquids, sigma dash. So this is the, using these values we can find out the heat flux in the nuclear boiling zone. Then another formula is also proposed to find the peak heat flux. Peak heat flux is given by peak heat flux. For the peak heat flux also one formula is given, yes, this is the expression used for finding the peak heat flux. This is the formula. Of course the dimension, the parameters are the same also, same only, but then the formula is, it is proposed by Juber and Tribus, proposed the following formula for finding the critical heat flux or peak heat flux. Okay, thank you.